My name is Roger Benowitz, and I'm a professor of agronomics and public policy. Every minute we sit here, 10 preschool-age children die of hunger and malnutrition. That's 6 million children each year. 800 million people don't even know where their next meal is coming from. They're what we in economics call food insecure. People are dying because their crops were destroyed, either by drought, insect plague, or disease spread through airborne bacteria. Had their crops been genetically immunized, they'd still be here today. The agricultural economy is a global economy and has been for some time now. If we cannot institute a global standard of crop immunization, then populations everywhere will suffer from famine and food-related illnesses. Therefore, universal crop immunization must occur. In the US and throughout most of Europe, we have thoroughly implemented a safe system of genetic crop immunization, while most of the world is still plagued by the instability of non-immunized crops. How would you like it if a delegation from Africa came to the US and suggested we not use genetic engineering in our medicine? We probably wouldn't like it very much. Why would we not use the best science can offer to solve our problems? Shouldn't they use the best science can offer to solve their problems? Famine, disease, poverty? Of course they should. It's the right thing to do.
One of everything on the menu.
So did we pass?
Everything checks out.
Awesome. Can I get you any coffee or any?
Yeah. Babe, I can't sleep.
Sleeping.
My name is Roger Benowitz, and I'm a professor of agronomics and public policy.
Every minute we sit here, 10 preschool-aged children die of hunger and malnutrition. That's 6 million children each year. 800 million people don't even know where their next meal is going. They're what we in economics call food. People are dying because they're soft food. Either by drought, insect plague, or disease that the airborne bacteria. While there's drops in genetically immunized, they'd still be here. The agricultural economy is a global economy and has been for some time now. If we cannot institute a global standard of crop immunization, then populations everywhere will suffer from famine and food availability. Therefore, universal crop immunization must be possible. In the U.S. and throughout most of Europe, we are poorly implemented. We probably wouldn't like it very much. Why would we not use the best science can offer to solve our problems?
My name is Roger Benowitz, and I'm a professor of agronomics and public policy.
Every minute we sit here, 10 preschool-aged children die of hunger and malnutrition. That's 6 million children each year.
Please, turn it off.
Don't even know where their next meal is coming from. There will be
please.
A call, food insecurity. People are dying because they're thirsty, either by drought,
see how easy that was.
Plague, or disease spread through airborne bacteria.
I can still hear it.
Had their crops been genetically immunized, they'd
Madam,
still be here.
You're not a queen.
The agricultural economy
it's classic.
Is a global economy and has been for some time.
If we cannot
institute a global standard of crop immunization, then populations everywhere will suffer from famine and food-related illnesses. Therefore, universal crop immunization must occur. In the U.S. and throughout most of Europe, we have thoroughly implemented a safe system of genetic crop immunization. In most of the world,
dirty boy.
Plagued by the instability of non-immunized crops. How would you like it if a delegation from Africa came to the U.S. and suggested we not use genetic engineering?
I see your family, man.
We probably
cute
wouldn't
little
like
girls.
Why would we not use the
they best mistake after their mother, huh?
To solve our problems. Shouldn't they use
tough
the best
crowd here.
To solve their problems? Famine, disease, poverty. Of course they should. It's the right thing to do.
My name is Roger Benowitz, and I'm a professor of agronomics and public policy. Every
well,
minute we
I,
sit
I get
here,
the sense
10 preschool-aged children die of hunger and
that
malnutrition.
Something's on your
That's
mind.
6 million children each year. 800 million people don't even know where their next meal is. There will be
talking usually helps me.
Food insecurity. People are dying because their crops were destroyed, either by drought.
Believe it or not, Stanley.
Or disease,
I'm not here to punish you.
Airborne bacteria.
I'm here to help
Had
you.
Had their crops been genetically immunized, they'd still be here.
But in order for me to do that,
economy is a global economy.
I'm going
to
need you to cooperate.
If we cannot institute a global
help
standard
me.
Of crop immunization,
help you.
Then populations everywhere
so what do you say?
Suffer from famine and food-related illnesses. Therefore, universal crop immunization must occur. In the U.S. and throughout most of Europe, we have thoroughly implemented a safe system of genetic crop immunization, while most of the world is
tough guy, huh?
By the instability of non-immunized crops. How would you like it if a delegation from Africa came to the U.S. and suggested we not use genetic engineering in our medicine? We probably wouldn't like it very much. Why would we not use the best science can offer to solve our problems? Most of Europe, we have thoroughly implemented a safe system of genetic crop immunization, while most of the world is still plagued by the instability of non-immunized crops. How would you like it if a delegation from Africa came to the U.S. and suggested we not...
Little sodium pent, never hurt anybody. Like,
why would we not use the best science can offer to solve our problems? Shouldn't they use the best science can offer to solve their problems? Shouldn't they use the best science can offer to solve their problems?
You'll be visiting one of our institutional physicians within the next 48 hours to receive a physical diagnostic. Any medical expenses attributed to our session will be covered under our insurance program. That doesn't include psychological damage, PTSD, things of that nature. However, we do have an in-house VA clinic that offers counseling that you are encouraged to visit. The IRS will be visiting your home to do an income as well as an asset audit to determine the amount owed to the state. After the source you provided is validated, we can begin sentence bargaining.
I need to eat.
What was that?
I need to eat.
Seriously? Look, you little shit, this is no time to prove a point. You either eat it or you starve.
Then I starve. Is that for me?
What was that all about?
What was what about?
What are you doing? I know you're sleep deprived, but you fall asleep that fast?
I was meditating.
What?
Meditating.
Meta what?
You wouldn't understand.
I don't know, man. One minute you sleep, the next minute you're awake. I'm just not getting you, man.
You can't just... You know what I'm saying? You're kidding me, right? I mean, like...
You felt me drawing on your face. Come on, don't give me this.
Oh,
so bright.
Been outside today?
It's a Saturday.
Got you some mochi.
From the supermarket?
Yeah.
No, thanks.
Sophia, did you move my pills?
Mom, Dad's home.
Honey, I thought you were leaving me for good.
I got you something.
Thank you.
I thought we'd have a good dinner tonight.
I'd love to, but I can't. I'm on medication.
Again?
What happened here?
Just a nosebleed on the line in the supermarket, man. Perfect timing.
That happens with sexual deprivation. That's what my nanny used to say. How was your trip?
Boring as usual.
You must be hungry. Mm-hmm. Sophia, can you get dinner ready?
Coffee's good, hon. Is the bagel in? Rachel? Rachel?
Yeah.
You think you could turn that down? Maybe the diet?
I don't eat wheat pasta anymore.
Why do you buy it?
I don't want to be a burden.
Burden? I don't even like pasta anymore. Sophia, what about you?
Yeah, pasta.
See? She doesn't like it neither.
The protein strand was on sale.
Didn't you say you wanted to stop eating meat?
You said that. So how was the lake?
It was great, wasn't it, sweetie? Ryan and Jen came up on Saturday to take us out on the water.
On the lake, yachting with Captain Ryan.
Speedboating.
He doesn't take the yacht out anymore. Says he's tired of being searched by Harbor Patrol.
If you could afford a yacht, there'd be no reason for you to be smuggling corn.
It's not always about money.
It's Doyle.
Doyle, this is Command Central.
Yeah?
There's been an incident with your recent 211.
Incident? What happened? What?
Rubio was an important target. We believe he had ties to one of the longest running grove sites of We're going to need you to come in and fill out a full detail report of his interrogation.
Right now? I just sat down for dinner.
I'm afraid that was not a request.
All right, I'm on it. I'll be out in a minute. Hey, honey. That was my job. They need me to come back in.
What? You just got home from a conference. Can they even do that?
They can do whatever they want. It shouldn't be too long. Just don't wait up on me.
What happened?
You know I can't discuss my job. It's nothing serious.
Well, hold on a minute. Jeez.
Honey, I really gotta go.
Well then, it can wait. I was saving this for your birthday. But I figured now is just as good a time as any. Aww. Happy birthday.
Thank you. Ooh. It feels amazing. Beautiful, perfect timing. Thank you.
Well, put it on. I got it from one of Jen's close friends. She's a designer.
Huh?
It's made from organic cotton.
Organic? As in non-immunized. Rachel. Cameras in the house.
Yeah, but not microphones. Besides, it's not written on the tag. What are they going to do, scan your shirt before you enter the building?
Yes. If they want to, they will.
Seriously, Jason, it's not that big of a deal. I mean, it's not like it's food or anything. Besides, you said it yourself. It feels nice.
I I go to prison.
For a shirt? Really?
Happy birthday!
It's Dad's birthday.